Hi everyone, it's Mimi, and today I'm going to be reviewing A Brief History of Seven Killings by Marlon James.
This book is centered around the attempted assassination of Bob Marley,
and we follow the events leading up to and the fallout afterwards through multiple POVs. The cast of characters is probably one of the most remarkable aspects about this book, with 75 characters and 10 narrators. You really get an interesting story being told between all of their different lenses. You hear from gang members and leaders, you hear from a dead politician, an FBI agent, an American journalist, a political strategist, and a woman who is representing the middle class who wants to leave Jamaica. In an interview, Marlon James said he didn't stop writing a character until he fell in love with them, and you can definitely see that by how well-formed these characters are, how clear their motives are, and even if you don't like a character because there's a lot of violence going on, a lot of very cruel things, and even though you might not like a character, which is very understandable, you can still be intrigued by their views towards the world, which I think is such talent. There's a quote in the book that I think is really telling to what Marlon James is trying to do in this book. It goes, "There's a version of this story that is not really about him, but about the people around him, the ones who come and go that might actually provide a bigger picture than the asking." And through this cast of characters, Marlon James covers in depth the slums of Kingston in the 70s. He goes through the crack wars in the 80s in New York and the Jamaican political climate and divide between the PNP and Labour Party from the 70s to the 90s. So if the cast of characters wasn't impressive, then maybe the 3 decades that Marlon James covers is. This book took about 4 years of research. I also watched a couple documentaries after reading this book, and it was pretty amazing the amount that I understood just from reading this book alone, so the research definitely shows. He often states in interviews that fiction is the lie that tells the truth, because the news is shaped by propaganda. Instead of just stitching together news sources and personal accounts, he also incorporates gossip into his literature because there's less holding back from gossip in a way. What I also found was interesting that he illuminated in one of his interviews was that one chapter is a version of another. The characters that you're following might be fighting the same battle or saying the same things or reflecting on the same thing each decade, even though the context changes, which I thought was super interesting. Another aspect of this book that I absolutely love is the writing style. Marlon James was raised thinking that a voice of anything sophisticated and artistic was what he needed to achieve as a writer. There's this myth of standard English, but he asserts that you can use the voice that you already have to express something that is just as complex, which is exactly what this book did.
No such thing as standard English. Using the voice that I already have as a way to speak to complexity and intensity and difficulty and violence and history. And I think writers such as myself, we got that from the musicians.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I think because...
Which musicians?
Like reggae musicians. That the idea that you could use, again, the voice that you come out of your mouth to speak to really complicated issues.
He's reshaping the tradition of what classic literature is looking for to include Jamaican poetry and slang. It was just a very unique and well-formed and thought-out book, and I really appreciate all the work that went into it.
Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption song.